Okay, in this video, I'll start my wrap-up of eclipses here, but I do want to sort of formalize a bit of the visuals and discussion here for you here and tell you about the two kinds of eclipses, solar and lunar eclipses. So I think you should know just about everything in here, but we'll just take a look again, a little more formal graphics and presentation. So on the first slide right here, this is what we mean by a lunar eclipse. And if you look very carefully here, this is where the Earth here has moved between the Sun and the Moon, right? That's the lunar case right here. The Earth here is the one that's in the middle blocking. Sun's over here, Moon's over here, Earth's in the way. You get the lunar eclipse. And what we see is not actually a darkening of the Moon to the point we can't see it, but this reddish light goes in here and starts to illuminate the Moon. And we get a little bit of our answer to question number 14. Which says, why does the Moon appear red during a full Moon lunar eclipse? We don't quite have the tools to answer that yet, but that's just something that happens. So I'm just sort of saying, what happens to the poor old Moon? Well, it actually does turn red. Question 14, this is an actual photograph of what would happen to the Moon during a lunar eclipse like that. You get this reddish hue. Sometimes they're called, even in the news here, the super blood wolf moon, blah, blah, eclipse of 2019. Again, blood, of course, implies that reddish color that we'll get. And we'll see why that happens. It has to do with the property of light as it goes through the atmosphere. But we'll see that in some future lectures. Some actual photographs of what that moon would look like. So this is the lunar eclipse here. So that's, again, where the Sun is here, the Earth is here, and the Moon is here. So it's the Earth here that's doing the blocking, get the reddish moon. Okay, and so then one of the questions that have also been answered in a video that I showed you with a little model is question number 29, is that why don't we see solar and lunar eclipses once a month? And of course, the idea behind that is that if the Sun is here, the Earth is here, and the Moon is here, as the Moon goes around the Earth like this, remember, the Moon takes a month to go around. Why don't we see an eclipse here? And then an eclipse a month later here. Then an eclipse a month later here. And, of course, the reason for that is this tilt. And so in this figure right here, you can just almost barely see it here. The more formalized graphics, here's the Sun, the Earth, and the Moon. And the Moon's orbit would be this circle right here. But as you can tell, it's tilted relative to the so-called ecliptic plane. Remember, this term came up a while back when we were talking about the celestial sphere. The ecliptic is the Sun's path through the skies, through the sky. That's always what ecliptic means in astronomy here. So that's sort of this big circle right here. And as you can tell, the Moon's path through the sky, which doesn't have a particular name, is tilted like that. And that tilt in here is something to the tune of about 5 degrees or so. So this tilted line here versus the tilt of the ecliptic, this little angle in here would be about 5 degrees. And that's why we don't see an eclipse once a month, is because, like in a case like this, if the Moon was in the way, it would be too low. It wouldn't be high enough up here to block the rays going to the Earth because of its tilt like that. So it just requires some particular alignment to happen before you'll actually see an eclipse. Incline about 5 degrees. Just sort of another graphic here. I always like looking at computer graphics for things. Earth, Moon, and here the orbit would be, say, above the ecliptic plane, which is this blue path right here, and there's a light ray coming from the Sun. And here's where the plane of the Moon's orbit dips below the ecliptic plane here. So if the Moon moved into this position, it would be too low to cause an eclipse to happen. It'd have to be a little higher or something like that. So it turns out that in recent memory here, there was a 2017 solar eclipse where that big shadow, now this is a solar eclipse, so this is, here's the Sun, the Moon, and the Earth, and so this is where the Moon was in the middle here, so the Moon was causing the blocking. So in something like, I forgot exactly when it was, August of 2017, there was going to be a time, which was very well advertised, where the Moon moved between the Sun and the Earth right in the middle of the day, okay? So this was a map of what happened here, that on that August 21st, 2017, as I said, NASA and scientists were able to predict where that shadow of the moon was going to appear during the day. So see, it went right across North America, which is very exciting because there's a lot of populated cities and people, a lot of people live near this path of totality. So you wouldn't see the eclipse necessarily here or here. You wouldn't see the full eclipse, but you have to go get yourself into this path in order to see it. And so this point right here is a city called Glendo, Wyoming. And I went there to go see the eclipse. I'll show you in the next video.